Hello everyone, this is Anamika from Galgudiya College of Engineering and Technology. We are here to study electromagnetic field theory, and in this class we will study electric flux density and Gauss law. So let's start. Well, electric flux density is nothing but the total line of field lines crossing a surface area. So, electric field intensity depends on the medium in which charge is placed, but electric flux density does not depend on any kind of media. So, we have defined this electric flux density as epsilon E. The electric flux phi in terms of D can be defined as phi is equal to d dot ds and d dot ds. The vector field D is called electric flux density and it is measured in coulomb per square meter. Sometimes this D is also known as electric displacement. Now, electric flux density for infinite set can be determined as this, because we have defined as D as epsilon E, and in all the previous classes we have already determined E for various type of charge configuration, like for point charge, for line charge, for surface charge, as well as for volume charge. So, as we already know the value of E in different cases, so we can easily find the value of D, which is a flux density or electric displacement, for all those cases using this formula. This is the D is equal to epsilon naught E, where D is the flux density, however E is the electric field intensity. In these are the two formula for electric flux density. First one is for infinite set. If you will place epsilon, it will give the E quantity, electric field intensity. For volume charge distribution, the electric flux density can be given by this formula. In both the above equations, D is function of charge and position only. It means that D does not depends on any kind of media. Now, let us know the Gauss law. Well, Gauss law states that the total electric flux through any closed surface is equal to the total charge. Means, suppose a charge is placed here inside a closed surface, then we know, we already have discussed that a positive charge radiates electric field lines outward. However, negative charge act as a sink for electric lines of force. So, if we will place Q inside here, then the line of electric line of force will radiate outward and it will cross this surface ds. Then we can find the value flux. Flux is nothing but the surface integral of d dot ds. So, flux can be defined as d dot ds, and total flux coming out from a closed surface will be equal to Q enclosed. Gauss law states that total electric flux through any closed path, closed surface, is equal to total charge enclosed by that surface. See, a closed path constitutes a surface. However, a closed surface constitutes a volume. So, it is a very important that the path should be closed. This is the formula for mathematical expression for Gauss law, that is a d dot ds, which defines total flux. If a vector, suppose a vector A, varying continuously in a definite region, continuous region with a surface area ds s, then total flux through this surface will be calculated with the help of surface integration of this vector A and this over the area ds. This is also known as flux of A passing through the area ds. But if the area will be closed, then this will be total outward flux, because closed surface constitute volume. So if the area will be closed, then it will be total outward flux. Now, according to Gauss law, total outward flux is equal to total charge enclosed, and total charge enclosed can also be written as rho v dv volume integral of rho v dv. So, we have written d dot ds, which is nothing but the total outward flux passing through the closed surface area ds, is equal to total charge enclosed by this closed surface area, that is a q, which can further be written like this, that is a rho v dv volume integration of rho v dv. Now, if we will take the divergence theorem, then we can write, you know that divergence theorem changes, transform surface integral to volume integral with the help of divergence. Suppose this is a d dot ds. If we apply divergence theorem on this, it will become, means first of all we will take the divergence of this d, then this ds will become dv, and this surface integral will change to volume integral. So, if we will take divergence theorem, then this surface integral will change to volume integral. So, according to Gauss law, it states that total flux is equal to total charge enclosed. Total flux can be written as d dot ds, where d is the electric flux density, also known as electric displacement, is equal to q enclosed. Q enclosed can be written as rho v dv. Remember, this is the flux density. However, this one is the charge density. This is the volume charge density. This is the electric flux density. Both are density. But this is the flux density, this is the charge density. Now, if we will apply divergence theorem on it, on the left side, apply left side we will get del dot d dv volume integral, and right side it will be equal to q enclosed, which can be written for the rho v dv. Now in both side we are having dv cancel out, both side we are having volume integral, so this term will be equal to this term. So finally we got the value of rho v is equal to del dot d. Gauss law gives the first Maxwell equation. This equation 1 is the integral form of first Maxwell equation or Gauss law. Equation 2 is known as the differential form of Gauss law or first law of Maxwell equation, first equation of Maxwell equation. This differential form is also known as point form. Point form or differential form. Okay, this one is the integral form of Gauss law, Gauss's law. Gauss law tells that the volume charge density rho v is equal to the divergence of electric flux density. Further, alternative statement, it is the alternative statement of Coulomb's law. It gives easy means to finding E or D for symmetrical charge distribution such as point charge and infinite charge, line charge and infinite cylindrical surface charge and a spherical distribution charge. Gauss law is basically used to find electric field or electric flux density for a symmetrical charge distribution. So, what is a symmetrical charge distribution? So, symmetrical charge distribution can be divided into three kind of symmetry. It can have rectangular symmetry. It means that distribution of charge will vary either according to x or y or z. In case of cylindrical symmetry, the distribution of charge will vary only with the rho, that is a radius of the cylinder. In spherical symmetry, the distribution of charge will vary according to the variation of radius. In a spherical coordinate, we are having r theta phi. So, in spherical symmetry will be considered if only r is varying, rest two quantity, that is theta and phi, are constant. Similarly, for cylindrical coordinate, it will be considered as cylindrical symmetry if only rho is varying, other two parameter, that is phi and z, are constant. So, we have seen that. Now, let us solve one problem over this. So, here one problem is this, means the aim of Gauss law is to find electric field in case of symmetry and also to find electric flux density. In this example, we are given a point charge, determine d at a point this, we need to find this d. If there is a point charge of minus 5 pi millicoulomb at 400 and a line charge of 3 pi millicoulomb per meter along y axis. Okay. So, in order to solve such kind of problem, first of all draw the axis and place all the charge at their proper place. So everything is given in rectangular coordinates, so we will draw a rectangular coordinate axis. This is a x, this is a y, and this is a z. Now at 4 0 3, means 4 on x axis, y axis 0, and on 3 somewhere here we need to find d. Determine d at this. If there is a point charge minus 5 pi millicoulomb at 400 400, means it will be here, means all other parameters are 0, only x axis are there, so it will be 400. At this point we are having minus 5 pi millicoulomb. Further, and a line charge of 3 pi millicoulomb per meter along y axis, means this is the y axis. In this we are having one line charge of value 3 pi millicoulomb per meter, means this is rho l. Rho l is given for this line charge. In the previous classes we have seen how to find the value of E for a line charge, for a point charge. So we need to apply that only, means we need to find the value of electric field for a point charge, that is a minus 5 pi millicoulomb, and for a line charge, that is a 3 pi millicoulomb per meter, using any law or direct formula you can find the value of E. Once you will get the value of E, you can find the value of D by using the formula that D is equal to epsilon E. Epsilon naught E. Well, so in order to find this, first of all we know that the value of E is equal to D will be, obviously it will follow superposition law. It means total net D will be equal to D due to point charge Q, and plus D due to the line charge DL. Suppose DQ is the flux density due to point charge and DL is the flux density due to line charge. Then let us find each one of them one by one. So DQ will be equal to epsilon E Q. So first of all find the EQ. EQE will be equal to Q by four pi. Epsilon will cancel out, so we will not write that. 4 pi R square. Now we need to find R here. Suppose call it R. R is nothing but the distance between this point where we need to find the value of D and where the point charge is located. So this distance is R1. Okay. Now what will be the value of R1? R1 will be equal to the final point minus initial point. Final point is 4 0 3, so it will be 4 minus 4 means 0, 0 minus 0 will be 0, 3 minus 0 will give 3. So the value of r is 3. Means this is the vector, we can write it as a 3 az, and the magnitude will be equal to 3 square root under, so it will be 3y. So it will be minus 5 pi millicoulomb divided by 4 pi the square of, we can write it as r on the top and here cube. So it will be 27, and here it will be multiplied by 3 az. This is the equation 1. We can simplify it little bit, then it will be dq will be equal to pi, and pi will cancel out, then it will be minus 5 millicoulomb divided by 4 multiplied by 27 az. Let us call it equation 1, not this. Now again we need to find the value of dl, and we know that dl is equal to, for a infinite a line of charge along the y axis, as here mentioned that a line of charge 3 pi millicoulomb per meter along y axis, it means that they are talking about the infinite line of charge. So we have already derived the formula for this, that we have already derived the formula for infinite line of charge, that rho l by 2 pi rho a rho l by 2 pi rho a rho. Okay. Where rho is the perpendicular distance between the point of interest where we want to find the value of electric field and the line axis on which line charge is residing. Further, rho l is the line charge density, which is given as 3 pi millicoulomb. So, we can write it as 3 pi millicoulomb per meter divided by 2 pi, pi pi will cancel out, and the value of rho we need to find. So, the value of the means we need to find this, as we know the coordinate of origin as 0 0, and the line between these will be perpendicular on this line, because this is the 3 dimensionally, it will not look like perpendicular in 2 dimensional space, but if you will imagine 3 dimensionally, you can visualize that if we will draw a line between this point 403 and origin, then it will be perpendicular on this line charge. So let us find the value of rho. Rho value will be equal to this final value 403 minus 000, it will give 4 ax plus 3 az, and arrow will be equal to, arrow will be equal to this is the rho vector. With the help of this we can find and rho also. So rho will be 4 square plus 3 square root under, and it will be 5. As we got the value of rho vector and rho, so we can get the value of a rho also. It will be rho vector divided by the magnitude of rho, which will be 4 by 5 a x plus 3 by 5 a y, sorry, a z. This is the unit value of unit vector a rho. Putting the value of a rho and rho, we can get the value of dl. So here dl will be equal to three millicoulomb per meter divided by two multiplied by 5 is the value of rho, and on the top numerator we will be having a rho. A rho is 4 a x plus 3 a z, so we will write 4 a x plus 3 a z. This is equation 2. Equation 1 is giving electric flux density due to point charge, and equation 2 is giving electric flux density due to line charge. After adding these two quantity, because electric flux as well as electric field intensity are the vector quantities, so final total flux density will come after adding this, and as it is a vector quantity, so we will take the summation, corresponding summation only. A x will add with A x only and A z will add with A z only. So total d will be equal to d q plus d l. After solving, it will come as a x plus 41.1 a z. Here we can see that in this term only a x and a z are there. In the first term only a z is there, a y is not present anywhere. So in final answer also you can see we are having a x and a z only. This is the final answer. So in this way we can solve such kind of problem. So in this class we have studied electric flux and how to solve if multiple charges and multiple kind of charges will be there, then how to solve the problem for electric flux density. In the next class we will see. We have also discussed about the Gauss law. In the next class we will see what is the application of Gauss law. Gauss law is basically used to solve electric field and electric flux density in easier way. It is just a modified way version of Coulomb's law. So in this class we will have seen and in further next class we will see the application. Till then, bye bye, thank you.